let's see now combination of resistors. So combination of resistor first combination is series combination. In series combination, resistances are joined in the circuit as shown here in the figure. Look at the figure. This is a potential difference we applied. Resistance R1, R2, R3 are connected in series. Potential difference across each resistance is different. Current through each resistance will be the same. So what are two important properties? Number one, current through each resistor each resistance is same and equal to total current in the circuit. Potential difference across each resistor or resistance is different, but the sum of potential differences is equal to total applied potential difference. So V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So you can put here Ohm's law, apply Ohm's law and put the values. IR equivalent, IR1, IR2, IR3, I gets cancelled. So R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. That's how you will find equivalent capacitance in series combination. Second is parallel combination. In parallel combination, these points are properties are reverse. Now potential difference across each resistance is same and equal to total applied potential difference. Current through each resistor is different. Through each resistance is different, but the sum of currents is equal to total current in the circuit. So in parallel combination, three resistances you will join like this. Connecting at the same point. Now these two ends you can connect to any EMF or potential difference source. Total current I, it gets divided into three set parts. Each resistor will carry different current, but finally current emerges out as I. Right? So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Again use Ohm's law, V over R equivalent is equal to V over R1 plus V over R2 plus V over R3. V cancels. So 1 over R equivalent is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. So if we look at these results, we can easily make it out, while we are combining resistances in series, effective resistance or equivalent resistance in the circuit increases. However, on combining resistors in parallel combination, effective or equivalent resistance of the circuit decreases. This is we can come to know by seeing the result. What point lies, where do I use this concept? You can use this concept. Suppose in the circuit you need 5 ohm resistance to be connected. You need 5 ohm resistance to be connected and you don't have 5 ohm resistance, then what you will do? If you have 1 ohm 5 resistors, so you can connect them in series. This will combine together and becomes 5 ohm. If you have 1 2 ohm and 1 3 ohm resistance, still you can obtain 5 ohm. If you have 2 2 ohm plus 1 1 ohm, still you can complete 5 ohm. So that is practical advantage of series combination. Similarly, you can do in parallel combination. Suppose I need a resistance equivalent to 0.5 ohm. And it is very difficult to obtain resistance of 0.5 ohm. So what to do? Take two resistances R1 equals to R2 each of value 2 ohm. Right? No, 1 ohm, 1 ohm each. And then check 1 over R equivalent is equal to 1 plus 1. R equivalent is equal to 1 by 2, 0.5. So if you connect two 1 ohm resistors in parallel combination, you can obtain 0.5 ohm resistor. That's what you need to require in your circuit. That's a one conceptual question. If I give you a VI graph, and this VI graph is plotted for series and parallel combination of resistors. By looking at VI graph, how do you identify that which combination or which line segment represents series combination and which shows parallel combination? Let's see. According to Ohm's law, R can be calculated from a graph equals to tan theta, that is equal to slope. VI graph gives resistance, slope of the VI graph. Angle of B is less than angle of A. Theta 2 is greater than theta 1. It means resistance represented by curve A is more than resistance shown by the curve B. Now go back as per the article and check. In series combination, effective resistance increases. However, in parallel combination, the equivalent resistance decreases. Since RA is greater than RB, so RA must be in C for series combination of resistors. However, B curve can be for parallel combination. Let's do two exercises, two questions on series and parallel combination. Basic concept is series and parallel combination. So series and parallel combination ke upar do badi achhi exercise hain, dekhiye. एक तो है कैलकुलेट रीडिंग ऑफ एमीटर एंड वोल्टमीटर इन डायग्राम. एमीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज विद 4 ओम रेजिस्टेंस. एक काम करो, पहले इसका इफेक्टिव रेजिस्टेंस निकाल लो. 4 ओम एंड 4 ओम, आई टेक दिस R1, दिस इज R2, दिस इज R3. R1 एंड R2 आर कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल. सो फर्स्ट फाइंड आउट R इक्विवेलेंट. R डैश इज इक्वल टू 1 ओवर R1 प्लस 1 ओवर R2, दैट इज 1 ओवर R इज इक्वल टू 1 ओवर 4 प्लस 1 ओवर 4, दैट कम्स आउट टू बी R डैश इज इक्वल टू 2 ओम. नाउ दिस R डैश, होल दिस R डैश इज इन कनेक्टेड विथ 2 ओम इन सीरीज. सो फाइनल इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस इज R डैश प्लस R3, that is 2 ohm plus 2 ohm, it is 4 ohm. Find current now. Current is voltage over resistance, that is R equivalent 8 volt divided by 4 ohm, that is 2 ampere. So you have got 2 ampere current is passing through a total circuit in the circuit. Now see, in parallel combination current divides into two parts or as many parts depending upon how many resistors you have connected in parallel combination. यहाँ R1 और R2 दो parallel combination में है, तो 2 ampere current जब इस junction पे पहुंचेगी तो divide कर जाएगी. 4 ohm की resistance है दोनों, तो 2 ampere जब divide करेगी तो equal parts में divide करेगी. 2 एम्पियर का 1 एम्पियर विल गो फ्रॉम अपर आर्म, 1 एम्पियर विल पास थ्रू लोअर आर्म. तो एमीटर की रीडिंग क्या होगी? एमीटर रीड्स, व्हाट इज एमीटर रीड्स? 1 एम्पियर, बिकॉज एमीटर इज कनेक्टेड इन द अपर आर्म और अपर आर्म में करंट कितनी फ्लो कर रही है? 1 एम्पियर, राइट. अब ये 1 एम्पियर यहां से यहां पहुंचेगी, ये 1 एम्पियर भी यहां पहुंचेगी, तो टोटल मिलके हो जाएगी 2. 2 एम्पियर इज नाउ फ्लोइंग थ्रू 2 ओम रेजिस्टेंस. तो पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस कितना आ गया? पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस 2 ओम आई इंटू आर 2 इंटू 2, दैट इज 4 वोल्ट. सिंपल क्वेश्चन. सी अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन सीरीज एंड कॉम्बिनेशन. ये कह रहा है कि टोटल करंट निकालो क्या है, ठीक है, इसके अक्रॉस पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस निकालो 4 ओम के, और करंट थ्रू 3 ओम निकालो, और क्या करना है, एक चीज और ऐड कर देते हैं आपके लिए, चलो काम हो जाएगा अच्छा सर, अप्लाइड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस भी निकालो. सी दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस विच मेक यूज ऑफ योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ सीरीज एंड पैरल कॉम्बिनेशन. सीरीज और पैरल कॉम्बिनेशन को आपने कितनी अच्छी तरीके से समझा है. इस 3 ओम रजिस्टर, दिस 3 ओम रजिस्टर इन सीरीज विद 4 ओम एंड दिस 2 आर, दिस 2 आर इन सीरीज विद 3 ओम के जो पैरल में कनेक्टेड, उनका जो भी इफेक्टिव आएगा, ठीक है. अब आप देखो, इस 3 ओम के अक्रॉस पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस कितना अपीयर कर रहा है? 1.5 वोल्ट. तो करंट निकाल दो इसमें, करंट इन 3 ओम रेजिस्टर. पहला काम ये करो, आई कितना आ गया? 1.5 डिवाइडेड बाई 3, आंसर इज 0.5 एम्पियर, ठीक है. नाउ दिस 0.5 एम्पियर इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू 3 ओम, so same amount of current will pass through because all these 3 1 2 3 are connected in series and in series combination current remains same. So from 4 ohm resistance will also 0.5 ampere current flow. So potential difference across 4 ohm kitna aa gaya? Current into resistance 0.5 into 4, आंसर 2 ओम. सेम करंट इज पासिंग थ्रू एयर, दिस विल डिवाइड इक्वली बिकॉज 3 ओम रेजिस्टेंस इज देयर. So 0.25, 0.25 will pass through here, 0.25 will pass through here. Right. So current through 3 ohm resistance, current through 3 ohm resistance is 0.5 divided by 2, that is 0.25 ampere each resistor. Now applied potential difference. Applied potential difference is this, your battery connect. For this you have to calculate first equivalent resistance. तो ये दो सीरीज में पैरेलल में, फिर ये सीरीज में है, आप नंबरिंग दे दो R1, इसे बोल दो R2, इसको बोल दो R3, इसे बोल दो R4, ठीक है. सो R3 इज पैरेलल टू R4, तो यहाँ पे R डैश क्या आ गया, R3 R4 डिवाइडेड बाय R3 प्लस R4, दैट इज 3 × 3 divided by 6, that is 3/2, 1.5 ohm. 1.5 ohm. Now R dash, R2 and R1 series में है, तो equivalent resistance क्या आ गया, R1 plus R2 plus R dash, that is 3 plus 4 ohm plus 1.5 ohm, कितना आया, 8.5 ohm. आ गया वोल्टेज, अप्लाइड वोल्टेज I × R equivalent. I कितना है, 0.5, ये कितना है, 8.5. कितना आ गया आंसर, 4.25 volt. ठीक है, That's how you can deal with the question. अब एक सीरीज पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन का क्वेश्चन भी देख लेते हैं. Let's see interesting question in series and parallel combination. एक सर्किट बना लेते हैं, बढ़िया सा. क्वेश्चन थ्री. क्वेश्चन है, फाइंड इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टर और रेजिस्टेंस बिटवीन ए बी इजी है. ये दोनों सीरीज में है, तो इनको एक साथ सीरीज में क्या आ गया, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ले लो. 1 and 3 are in series. 1 and 2 are in series. तो इसका R dash क्या आ गया, या R1 ले लो. R1 क्या आ गया, 4 plus 4 ohm is equal to 8 ohm. 4 and 5 are in series. 4 and 5 are in series. R2 निकालो, equivalent capacitance क्या आ गया, 3 ohm. प्लस 3 ohm is equal to 6 ohm. अब तीन आपके रेजिस्टेंस जो सर्किट है, दैट गेट्स रिड्यूस इनटू दिस फॉर्मेट. थ्री रेजिस्टर्स आर इन पैरेलल, दिस इज 8 ohm, दिस इज 6 ohm, दिस इज 2 ohm. फाइन. सो आर इक्विवेलेंट is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. 1 over 8 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 6 LCM ले लो. क्या आएगा, 24, 3, 12, 4, 16, 19 by 24. Is it okay? LCM 24, 3, 12, 4, then 4 plus 12, 16 plus 3, 19. So R equivalent is equal to 24 over 19 ohm. If you want to calculate this, calculate, it will be around 1.2 around.